The bovine ovary varies significantly in size through the estrus cycle. It is also affected significantly by the nutritional state of the animal. Non-cyclic cows in a negative energy balance have small, inactive ovaries, while those of actively cycling cows are much bigger and may have various structures in or on them. The ovary is contained in a pouch known as the ovarian bursa. To visualize it, you need to take it out of its pouch, which I've done here. When palpating the ovaries of the cow per rectum, it's important to have some sort of system to orientate you. For example, you may want to describe the position of a corpus luteum or of a very large follicle. You can't use the normal anatomical directions like cranial, caudal, medial and lateral because the ovary is so mobile and what was cranial 5 minutes ago might be lateral now. Instead, we use the relative location of the surrounding anatomy to describe the orientation of structures on the ovary. In one set of directions, we have the free margin and the bursal margin. The free margin has no attached tissue while the bursal margin is where the ovary attaches to the tissue that forms the ovarian bursa. Think of these as east and west. The next set of directions describes the pole of the ovaries, north and south. The easiest pole to palpate is the ligamentous pole, which is formed by the proper ligament of the ovary, which attaches the ovary to the uterus. This ligament is strong and quite fibrous. You can pluck it, almost like a guitar string. The last pole is the most difficult to palpate. We call this the tubular pole, since the uterine tube or fallopian tube is at this end. Here you can see an ovary with a prominent corpus luteum, as well as a well-developed follicle. We describe the position of this CL as being midway between the free margin and the bursal margin, and at the ligamentous pole of the ovary. This CL forms the classic shoulder or button on the surface of the ovary, but most of it actually lies inside the ovary. The follicle is on the free margin, midway between the tubular and the ligamentous pole. As I cut into the ovary, you can see the follicle contains a lot of fluid. The fluid-filled region of the follicle is known as the follicular antrum. The hormone-secreting cells of the follicle are around the edges of this fluid-filled structure. The corpus luteum, by contrast, is filled of a solid mass of highly active endocrine tissue. It's amazing to think that in just a few days, a Gravian follicle is able to completely transform itself into a corpus luteum and totally change the hormones that it secretes. The contralateral ovary of this reproductive tract specimen is relatively small and inactive. You can see corpora albicantia, which are old corpora lutea from previous cycles.